चला स्टार्ट। हेलो राइट, वील कंटिन्यू विथ शंट क्लिपर्स। सो आई हैव पोस्टेड द वीडियो, ओके, प्लीज डू लुक एट दैट सीरीज क्लिपर्स। आई हैव डिस्कस्ड 2+4 6 सर्क्यूट्स, ओके, विच आर मोर देन इनफ फॉर दिस सीरीज क्लिपर्स। इन ए सिमिलर वे we will be considering 6 circuits in the shunt clippers also, okay, right? So please do go through with that, and if you have any questions I can answer them maybe during the course of time, okay, right? Our target here is to plot the transfer characteristics, relationship between input voltage and output voltage, and using the transfer characteristics I need to plot the output response for the given input, which is a sinusoidal input, okay, right? So this is how I am proceeding. I'll start with an assumption, okay, that my diode is on. Whenever my diode is on, I know that I can replace my diode with a short circuit. So when I replace my diode with a short circuit, what is all that I can do? I can replace my diode with short circuit so that my output voltage is straight away zero. Okay, my output voltage is zero. Why my output voltage is zero? Because my diode has been shorted. Across the diode I am taking the output voltage, so that is my V naught is zero. Okay, right? Okay, fine. So what is all that I have to do is I have to find my current through the diode. So my current direction will be in this direction, that is always from P side to the N side. So if I find that this I is positive, my diode is forward biased. If this I is negative, my diode is reverse biased. So can I find the value of my I or expression for my I? Yes, I can. Okay, so I'll apply my KVL. So I into R plus 0 minus VI is equal to 0. Okay, so what is my I can write it as I can write it as VI by capital R. Okay, I can write it as VI by capital R. Now you tell me, for what value of VI my I is going to be positive? Okay, whenever my VI is positive, okay, whenever my VI is positive, my I is going to be positive. When my I is positive, I know that my diode is on. Whenever my diode is on, okay, I know that my output is zero. Okay, why? Because diode replaced with short circuit, output is zero. Okay, similarly, when my VI is negative, okay, when my VI is negative, my I is going to be negative. Okay, VI negative, I is negative. Then my diode is going to be off. Then my diode is going to be off, right? So whenever my diode is off, I'll replace that with an open circuit. Okay, so when this is an open circuit, when I look at my voltage in between these two nodes, what is my output voltage is being given by open circuit means no current. Okay, please do understand, if this is an open circuit, can the current can flow like this through the R? No. Okay, so current through the R is zero, that means voltage drop across R is zero, that means my output voltage from these two nodes is same as my input voltage in between these two nodes. Okay, so whenever my diode is off, my output is going to be same as my input voltage. Okay, my output is going to be same as my input voltage. Okay, all right, is this fine? I have started with an assumption that my diode is on. With my diode is on, my diode can be replaced with short circuit. Upon assumption or replacing my diode with short circuit, I am trying to find the current flowing through the diode from P side to the N side, and I represented my current through the diode with I. I am trying to look for whether my I is positive, my diode is forward biased, I is negative, diode is reverse biased. So thereby I am trying to write an expression for my I, applying KVL, I into R minus VI is equal to 0. So I is equal to VI by R. So now I can come to know for what range of input signal my current is going to be positive. Thereby I can say that my diode is forward biased or reverse biased. Okay. So for my VI is greater than 0, my V0 is 0, and my VI is less than 0, my V0 is I. Okay. So now let me draw the transfer characteristics with the help of this information. Okay. For my VI positive in this direction, okay, my V0 is 0. So my V0 is 0. Okay. Whenever my VI is positive, that is greater than 0 volts, my output voltage is 0. When my VI is negative, my output voltage is same as the input. Okay. For all my input negative, my output voltage is same as the input. So this is the transfer characteristics of the circuit that is given to us. Now let us use this transfer characteristics for obtaining the input waveform. What is the input waveform? The input waveform is like a dotted line. Okay. So this dotted curve representing your sinusoidal waveform, assuming that it is starting at 0 seconds. Okay. Now let us use this for drawing the output waveform. What is the transfer characteristics is telling? From this point to this point, my input is positive. When my input is positive, my output is 0. So for this time duration, my output is 0. Whenever my input is negative, my output has to be same as the input. From this point to this point, my input is negative. That means my output has to follow the input. Okay, my output has to follow the input. And from this point, my input is positive. Whenever my input is positive, output has to be 0. Okay. Input negative, output follows the input. Input positive, output is 0. Input negative, output follows the input. Okay. So this is what is your output. Right. Can you give the name to this particular circuit? What the name that I can give to this? Just like a positive clipper or a negative clipper, what is the name I can give?
Positive clipper.
Why positive clipper?
Because
positive portions of my input signal has been clipped off. That is why it is called as positive clipper. Okay? Right? So sometimes one may ask you that given a positive clipper. Okay? Given a positive clipper with a no reference voltage. Okay, what it should get into your mind is maybe a circuit like this. Okay, right? So is this fine? Okay, in whatever the circuits that we are going to consider, our only primary focus is on drawing the transfer characteristics, using it for drawing the output response, that's all. Okay, fine. So we'll move on to one more circuit. This is the circuit that is given. Okay. This is the circuit that is given. Please try yourself to draw the transfer characteristics and from which you need to draw the output response. Make it fast. I will be asking randomly one number so that you need to answer, or you need to show your answer script or your notebook, whatsoever it is, so that everyone can see what you have done. Okay, so make it faster. This is the circuit for which you need to draw the transfer characteristics as well as you need to draw the output response. So assuming that the input signal is a sinusoidal input signal. So make it faster. Okay, so look at the board, everyone. So this is one more circuit. Okay, this is another type of circuit, but nevertheless a shunt circuit only. Okay, shunt clipper. Okay, so let us start with an assumption that let us start with an assumption that my diode is on. Whenever my diode is on, I'll replace my diode with short circuit. When I replace my diode with short circuit, so my circuit is going to look like this. Okay, this is how my circuit is going to be. This is my R, this is my output voltage, right? So my current that is flowing is now assumed to be always from P side to the N side. Let it be denoted by I. Okay, so if my I is positive, I'll say that my diode is forward biased. If my I is negative, my diode is going to be reverse biased. Okay, so can I write an expression for my I? Yes, I can. Okay, so this is 0 I into R plus VI is equal to 0, from which I can write my I is equal to minus VI by R. Okay, my I is equal to minus VI by R. Now I can understand that for what value of my VI, my I is going to be either positive or negative. Okay, for my VI is negative. Whenever my VI is negative, 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 positive, my I is going to be positive. When my I is positive, I know that my diode is on. Okay, I know that my diode is on. Whenever my diode is on, I will be replacing my diode with short circuit, so that my output is going to be 0. Okay, my output is going to be 0. Right. Similarly, when my VI is greater than 0, when my VI is positive, positive into negative is negative, my I is going to be negative. When my I is negative, I know that my diode is going to be off. Okay. When my diode is off, I'll be replacing my diode with an open circuit. Open circuit means no current can flow. When there is no current, no drop across the R, that means my output voltage is same as my input voltage. Okay. So my output voltage is same as my input voltage. Okay. So depending upon whether my input is negative or input is positive, I could know what is my output is. Okay, right? Okay. So we'll be using this information for drawing the transfer characteristics. Whenever my input is negative, my output is 0. My input is negative, my output is 0. Okay, this is the axis. Okay, less than 0, my input is negative. Okay, so that my output is going to be 0. Whenever my input is positive, my output is same as the input. Okay, my output is same as the input. Okay, so for all my input greater than 0, okay, my output has to be same as the input. So these are the transfer characteristics for this given circuit, what we were able to draw. Okay, now we will use this transfer characteristics for drawing the output response. Okay, it is simple to draw the output response from the transfer characteristics. Okay, so the key here is just plotting the transfer characteristics. Sometimes you will be asked to plot the transfer characteristics alone, assuming that drawing the output response from the transfer characteristics is not at all a matter. Okay, so here is a dotted curve representing your input signal, a sinusoidal signal, assuming that it is starting at t is equal to 0 and it is a function of time. Okay, for all my input negative, my output is 0. Okay, from this point, my input is positive. Whenever my input is positive, my output has to follow the input. Whenever my input is negative, my output has to be 0. Okay. For this duration of time, my input is negative. That is why my output is 0. Whenever my input is positive, my output has to follow the input. Okay. Whenever my input is negative, output is 0. Okay. Whenever my input is positive, output has to be same as the input. For negative input, output is. So this is how my output is going to look like for this particular circuit when a sinusoidal input is being applied. Okay, so this shaded curve is representing your output. And what name that I can give to this circuit? What
negative
name?
Clipper. Negative clipper.
Very good. Negative clipper. Okay, because the negative portion of the input signal has been clipped off by the given circuit. You are calling this circuit as a negative clipper. Okay, a negative clipper. Right? So, is this okay? We have considered the fundamental circuits, which are shunt clippers. One is called as positive clipper, another is called as a negative clipper. Okay? Right. So now we'll consider one more circuit, okay, which involves the reference voltage. Okay. So whenever we are using a reference voltage, it is likely that we are having a more control over our circuit in getting our desired output. Okay. Right. I'll draw the circuit, but nevertheless, you just try yourself to find out the transfer characteristics. Even if you don't get it, no issue. Okay, I'll redo it again. But for the time being, I'll be finishing my drawing. Okay, you can try yourself getting your transfer characteristics and output response. Okay. Okay, so this is the circuit. Okay, this is called as a shunt clipper. You know why the reason is. Okay, just go ahead with our procedure, whatever we have. Okay, in drawing the transfer characteristics and thereby obtaining the output response from the transfer characteristics. So this is the circuit. Okay. Okay, so I am done with my drawing. Okay, so let us start, right? So our target is, as usual, drawing the transfer characteristics and using it for drawing the output response. Okay, it doesn't matter whatever the circuit that is given. Okay, irrespective of what type of circuit that is given, no issue. We are always interested in drawing the transfer characteristics, and we have to use it for drawing the output response. That's all. Okay, an assumption, okay, that my diode is on. Okay, I have started with an assumption that my diode is on. So with the assumption that my diode is on, I'll be replacing my diode with short circuit. Okay, so I'll replace my diode with a short circuit. Okay, so what is that I have done is, upon assumption of my diode is on, okay, I replaced my diode with short circuit. Thereby, I am interested in finding my current, okay, flowing through the diode always from P side to the N side. Okay, so I don't know whether you have observed or not, I am always assuming my current flow through the diode is always from P side to the N side. So that only under that assumption, I can say that if my IE is found to be positive, I'll say that my diode is forward biased. And if my I is negative, I'll say that my diode is reverse bias. If I choose in the other way, that is flowing from N side to P side, whatever I choose here is not right. Okay, so please do confine choosing your current flow through the diode is always from P side to the N side, and then only you say that if your current is positive, diode is forward biased. If your current is negative, diode is reverse bias. Okay, right. So can I write the equation for my I? Yes, I can. Okay, I'll be applying the KVL. Okay, I'll be applying the KVL. I'll start from here. Capital VR plus, sorry, minus VI, okay, plus I into R is equal to 0. Okay, so from which I can write my I is equal to VI minus VR by capital R. Okay, VI minus VR by capital. Now you can easily tell me what is the value of your VI such that your I is going to be positive. Okay. For what value of my I is going to be positive? Whenever my VI is greater than VR, okay, whenever my VI is greater than VR, my I is going to be positive. My I is going to be positive. If my I is positive, I know that my diode is going to be on. Whenever my diode is on, what is the voltage I am looking my voltage in between these two nodes. Replacing your diode with short circuit, your output voltage is always looking like your VR itself. So my output voltage is equal to VR itself. Okay. For my VI greater than VR, my output voltage is VR. Okay. For my VI less than VR, whenever my VI is less than VR, this entire thing is negative. That means my I is going to be negative. When my I is negative, I know that my diode is said to be in the off state. Okay. If your diode is in the off state, I'll say that my diode can be replaced with an open circuit. Whenever this is an open circuit, no current can flow. Okay. That means the current through the R is zero. Whenever my current through the R is zero, drop across R is zero. That means the voltage from these two nodes, okay, which is the output voltage, is same as the input voltage. Please do understand. Okay. Don't think that it is open circuit. This is also not there. This is not there. But so what? You are always looking your output from these two nodes. In between these two nodes is what is that you are considering as your output. So from these two nodes is same as these two nodes, which is nothing but your output. Okay. So my output voltage is going to be my input voltage. Okay. My output voltage is going to be my input voltage. So I'll be using this information for drawing the transfer characteristics. Okay, so whenever my VI is greater than VR, output is same as VR. Whenever my VI is less than VR, output is equal to VI. So that means my output is literally dependent on my input is greater than VR or input is less than VR. So I have to locate first where is my VR is. Okay, I'll be locating my VR somewhere here. Okay, I'll be locating my VR somewhere here. Okay. On the output axis also, I'll be locating my VR. Please understand, VR means what? Some DC power supply. Okay, some DC source. Okay, battery voltage. Let it be 2 volts, 3 volts, 5 volts, whatsoever it is. So just locate that VR on the input side. For example, VR is 5. Let us say that this is my input voltage at 5 volts. At your output voltage also, you could have the 5 volts. That I am representing with VR. So with this VR and this VR, both are been same. Both are numbers, but one is representing that your input is this number, another is representing that your output is this number. Okay. So now you look at here. Whenever my input is greater than VR, that means what? Where is my input? My input, whenever it is greater than this VR, my output is going to be VR itself. Okay. My output is going to be VR itself. Okay, whenever my VI is less than VR, my output is same as input. How do I represent that my output is same as input? So this is how I'll represent. Okay, so these are the transfer characteristics. Okay, these are the transfer characteristics which we will be using for obtaining the output response. Okay, so here is the dotted curve, our sinusoidal input signal, assuming that it is starting at zero as a function of time, and you know that depending upon whether your VI is greater than VR or less than VR, your output is being decided. So you need to locate first your VR. Okay. So I am locating first my VR. Okay. So I am locating first my VR. Okay. Let us say that VR. VR can be any number. Okay. Some positive number. Okay. VR is positive number. Okay. So just look at that, whether your input is, as your input is varying with respect to time, observe that whether your input is either greater than this VR value or less than this VR value. Greater than this VR value, output is same as VR only. Less than this VR value, output is equal to the input. Okay. So from here to here, my input is less than VR. Whenever my input is less than VR, okay, my output has to follow the input. Okay. My output has to follow the input. So from here to here, my input is less than VR, then my output has to follow the input. But from this point to this point, my input is greater than VR, okay? From this point, my input is greater than VR, okay? Whenever my input is greater than VR, my output is VR itself, okay? From here to here, my input is greater than VR, that means my output is VR itself. But from this point, my input is less than VR. Whenever my input is less than VR, my output has to follow the input. Okay, my output has to follow the input. Okay, when my input is greater than VR, from this to this point, my input is greater than VR. Whenever my input is greater than VR, my output is my output is same as the Vi. Okay, my output is same as Vi. So when my input is less than Vr, output has to follow the input. So output has to follow the input. Okay, output has to follow the input. And for my input is greater than Vr, for this duration where my input is greater than Vr, my output has to follow the Vr itself. Okay, for my input less than Vr, my output has to follow the input. So my output has to follow the input. Okay, right? So this is how my output is looking like. Okay, all right. So we have taken a reference. Okay, we have taken the reference, right? But you are trying to select a portion of your input signal below the reference level. Okay, above the reference level you are clipping off, but below the reference level you are trying to select your input signal. Okay, right? Okay, so we'll move on to the next circuit. Okay, we'll move on to the next circuit, right? Okay. So I'll represent that this shaded waveform as this shaded waveform is our output. Okay, right. So now you have to do one circuit of yourself. Okay, now you have to do one circuit of yourself. Just I'll change the diode direction. I will not do this. Okay, I will not do this. Okay, you have to do yourself. Okay, so this is the circuit, right? You only have to do, I will not do this, I will go with another circuit. Okay, so please do take up this circuit. We will not be doing this circuit right now. You have to do it yourself because it is exactly similar to what we have considered in the previous circuit. Okay, so just take down the circuit so that you will be proceeding yourself next to earlier circuit. Okay, so take it first.
Sir?
చెప్పమ్మా
సార్, మనం అవుట్పుట్ వేవ్ ఫామ్ సైన్సోయిడ్ ఎంత తీసుకుంటున్నాం, స్క్వేర్ వేవ్ ఫామ్ ఇవన్నీ ఉన్నాయి కదా సార్.
స్క్వేర్ వేవ్ ఫామ్ కూడా ఇన్పుట్ తీసుకోవచ్చు అంటారు, అంతేనా?
ఎస్ సార్.
అంతేనా? యా, యూ కెన్ టేక్ స్క్వేర్ వేవ్ ఫామ్ ఆల్సో యాజ్ యువర్ ఇన్పుట్, నో ఇష్యూ. ఇఫ్ యూ సీ, యువర్ అవుట్పుట్ ఈస్ డిపెండెంట్ ఆన్ వాట్? ఇర్రెస్పెక్ట్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ ఇన్పుట్, యువర్ అవుట్పుట్ ఈస్ డిపెండెంట్ ఆన్ వాట్? యువర్ అవుట్పుట్ ఈస్ ఆల్ డిపెండెంట్ ఆన్ whether your input is greater than the reference voltage or less than the reference voltage. Yes or no? And what is all that your output is? Your output is either it is equal to Vr or it is following the input signal. What is that? It is either a sinusoidal waveform or a square waveform. Your output has to be same as the input. No issue what is the input signal that you are considering. Is it not? What is that? The expressions for your output are telling you my output is same as the input or my output is same as the reference level. Let it be a constant. That is going to be a constant. It is no more dependent on the input. And if it is dependent on the input, my output is same as the input. Even if you consider a square waveform or triangular waveform, your output is going to be the same. Okay? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, right. So let us go ahead with this circuit. Okay, so what is the important point here is, here the battery is being represented like minus plus. So that means if this Vr is positive, that means you are representing a negative battery. Suppose Vr is 5 volts, what battery it is? Minus 5 volts battery. Okay, right. Or sometimes if you represent your battery with always plus sign and minus sign, then you have to represent this Vr with minus Vr. If your interest is to represent a negative number, either way is same. Okay, don't get confused. Okay, so right. So let us start with an assumption that assume my diode is on. Okay, assume my diode is on. Whenever my diode is on, I'll be replacing my diode with short circuit. Okay, so I'm replacing my diode with a short circuit. I'm drawing the equivalent circuit. Okay, so upon assumption that my diode is on, I can replace my diode with short circuit. I have replaced my diode with short circuit, but I have to find out the current through the diode. I am assuming that always from P side to the N side and denoting that with I. Okay, if my I is positive, I'll say that my diode is forward biased. If my I is negative, I'll say that my diode is reverse biased. Okay, so can I write an equation? Yes, I can. Okay, so I'll be writing the KVL in this loop. Okay. So plus VR, right? Plus I into R, okay? Plus I into R plus VI is equal to 0. Okay? Just applying KVL, I can come up with this particular equation. Okay? From which I can write my I is equal to, what is that my I is equal to? This VI is going to become minus VI when I bring it onto the right hand side. Plus VR is going to become minus VR when I bring it onto the right hand side. So I am writing minus of VI plus VR by capital R. Is this okay? Minus VI minus VR by R. So minus of minus VI plus VR by R. This I am able to write it. Okay. Right. So look at here how I am writing. I am writing like minus VR. Is this okay? Is there any difference? No difference. Minus into minus is plus. VI plus VR within brackets. And I am ending with minus, which is same. Okay? Right? Okay. Now you tell me, for what value of my VI, my I is going to be positive. Whenever the term inside the brackets is positive, my I is going to be negative. Whenever the term inside the brackets is negative, negative into negative positive, my I is going to be positive. And you know that if your I is positive, you say that your diode is forward biased, replace with short circuit. If your I is negative, replace your diode with an open circuit because diode is said to be in the reverse bias. Okay? Right. So tell me that when my VI is, okay, greater than minus VR, okay, when my VI is greater than minus VR, that means term within the brackets is positive into negative is negative, so I is negative. Whenever I is negative, diode is off. When my diode is off, okay, I am replacing my diode with an open circuit. Open circuit means no current flows through the R. Then my output voltage from here to here is same as my input voltage because no drop here, okay, no voltage drop here. So my output voltage in between these two nodes is same as the input voltage. So my output voltage is equal to, okay, my output voltage is equal to same as the VI, okay. Similarly, when my VI is less than minus VR, okay, when my VI is less than minus VR, okay, this is a negative, positive, so my I is going to be positive. When my I is positive, you know that diode is going to be on, okay, you know that diode is going to be on. If your diode is on, you replace with short circuit, and now you observe your output from this point to this point. What is that? You could see your output voltage is same as your minus VR. Okay, same as VR, I'll say. Okay, same as VR, I'll say. VR can be any number. Okay, same as VR, I'll say. Okay, but what is VR is a negative battery. Please do understand. Okay, when I'm writing VR means you have to understand that VR is a negative battery. Okay, right. Suppose if VR is 2, what does it mean? Minus 2 volts is the battery. Okay? Right. So, I'll use this information for drawing the transfer characteristics. Okay? I'll use this information for drawing the transfer characteristics. Okay? So, where I should locate my VR, because anyway my output is always dependent on what is my VR is. But where I should locate my VR here? VR is positive or negative here? VR is a negative
minus
here.
X, sir.
negative.
Negative, very good. So where I can locate? Negative means it will be somewhere here. Okay. My output voltage, value of my VR on the output axis can be located somewhere here. And the value of my VR on the input axis can be located somewhere here. Okay. Suppose my VR is 5. That is nothing but minus 5. Okay. So minus 5 is located here. My output is at minus 5. That is what it can be located here. Okay. So now you see that when my VI is greater than minus VR, output is same as the input. When my VI is less than minus VR, output is equal to VR. When my VI is less than minus VR, suppose that this VR is 5. I am at minus 5. VI is less than minus VR. That means what? Where I should go? I should go towards the left side or towards the right side. If this is for minus 5, VI is less than minus 5 means what? VI is less than minus 5 means what values of VI? VI is less than minus 5 means what values of VI? Less than minus 5. That means minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, and so on up to minus infinity. Those are the values which are greater than, which are less than minus 5. Yes or no? Greater than minus 5 means minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, and so on up to infinity. Okay. For my VI is less than minus VR, my output is same as the VR itself. So that means how do I represent? I'll represent that. Is this okay? Please understand carefully. From this value of my input, when I am moving towards the left hand side up to the minus infinity, I am saying that my input signal is less than minus VR. Okay. If this is minus 5, less than minus 5 means minus 6, minus 7, and so on up to minus infinity. For all those values of input, you are saying that your output is VR. So that is why my output is VR up to minus infinity. But once your VI is greater than minus VR, okay, any value of your input greater than minus 5 is minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. For all those values of your input, your output is same as the input. So my output is same as the input. Okay. So this is what is the transfer characteristics of your circuit that is given. When once you are comfortable in drawing the transfer characteristics, so there ends the matter, it will be very convenient for you to plot the output response. Okay. So let us try to use this transfer characteristics for plotting the output response. Okay. Right. So let us consider a dotted curve. Okay. Or sinusoidal waveform. Okay. Varying from 0 to infinity. Assuming that it is starting at 0. Okay. And it is a function of time. So what is all that my output is dependent on? My output is dependent on a reference level, and that too it is at minus. So where I can locate my reference level? I'll be locating my reference level somewhere here, because it has to be a negative, yes or no? My reference level has to be a negative number. Okay, this is fine. Why I am representing in the negative axis? Because my VR is negative. Okay, right. Just now you just try to observe that whether your VI is greater than VR or less than VR. Okay, so VR is this. This line is representing your VR. Observe that whether your VI is greater than VR or VI is less than VR. Okay. So when my input is from this point to this point, what do you say about your VI? My VI is greater than this VR. Yes or no? Right? My VI, suppose if this is minus 5. Okay. When my input is somewhere here, it is at minus 4 or less than minus 5. That means it is more than my VR. So from this point to this point, okay, my input is greater than VR. Whenever my input is greater than VR, my output has to be same as the input. So that is from this point to up to this point, my output has to follow the input. Okay. And whenever my input is less than this VR, okay, see these are negative, okay. With a negative symbol, larger numbers are less. Okay. With a positive symbol, larger numbers are greater in value. Okay. So whenever my VI is greater than this, less than this VR, then my output is going to be same as VR. Okay. So my output has to be same as VR. When my input is greater than VR, output has to follow the input. Okay. When my input is less than VR, my output has to be same as VR. Greater than VR, output has to follow the input. Okay. Less than VR, output has to be same as the VR. Greater than input, greater than VR, output has to be following the input. Okay, right. So we have considered a reference line. Okay, we have considered a reference line, right? you have considered a reference line and you are trying to select the portion of the input signal above that reference line. Is this okay? Right? So this is what I am representing with your output voltage. Okay? This is what is your output voltage. Is this fine? Obtaining the transfer characteristics for the given circuit and thereby drawing the output response of the given circuit. Okay? So I will change the circuit so that you have to do that circuit by yourself only. Okay? Okay, so this is the circuit. So this is the circuit. I'll arrange everything. Okay. So just try to do it yourself so that I'll take the attendance. Fine.